The fan mode has several special functions in the Chimp, and can be used on all attributes. In this chapter, we will therefore discuss the fan mode in detail. Thank you for your interest in the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, and welcome to this tutorial. To learn more about the various parts of the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, keyboard, and screen, you are advised to watch Tutorial 1 and 2, Hardware and Software. This tutorial is based on software version 1.3. If your Chimp uses a different software version, the functions or user interface may be different. Please note that we refer to the Chimp hardware keys as keys and the GUI software keys as buttons in this tutorial. Fan mode. We select IS100 fixtures and set the intensity to 100% so that we have an output. We then select position in the attributes screen. If we now rotate encoder 1, the pan function, we can see that all the fixtures are given the same values. To activate the fan mode, we press the fan key on the Chimp. If we rotate encoder 1, we can see that the values are distributed equally across the 8 fixtures that have been selected. The position attribute can therefore be used to quickly create some fantastic settings. If we rotate encoder 2, we can see that the tilt values are also distributed equally across the selected fixtures. In order to explain the fan mode, we select position. However, fan mode can be used with all the attributes. We'll show you an example of this at the end of this tutorial. Fan mode options. The fan mode has several options, which are visible in the bottom toolbar at the bottom right of the screen. To select the various options, we tap on the fan mode button to the right in the button toolbar. The fan mode is set to fan center as standard. We now select the fan left function. If we now rotate encoder 1, we see that the values are not distributed from the middle, but from the left side. If we now select the fan right function, we see that the values are distributed across the selected fixtures from the right side. For the next example, we now select the standard setting again by tapping on the fan center button. In the toolbar for the fan mode menu, we see the grouping option, which is set to off by default. We tap on the grouping button. We can now enter a number of groups. In this example, we choose 2. This means that groups are made with 2 fixtures. If we now rotate encoder 1, we can see that the selected fixtures move in groups of 2. We now tap the grouping button again, and now enter the value 4. This means that we can create groups of 4 fixtures. If we now rotate encoder 1, we can see that the fixtures move in groups of 4. In the toolbar of the fan mode menu, we can see a reset option. If we tap this button, we will restore all fan functions back to the default. We can see that the grouping is set to off again, and that the fan is set to center. Fan function and grouping. We will now apply a fan function to 3 groups. To do so, we must first select the three groups of eight fixtures. In our example, the IS-100, the IS-200, and the IS-400. We will set the grouping to eight fixtures. To do so, we tap on the fan mode button, and then on the grouping button. We enter the value 8. This means that we have now created groups of eight fixtures, so three groups in total. We now activate the fan function by pressing the fan key. By rotating encoder 1, we see that we can make the three groups of eight fixtures move in a fan. Fan function and attributes. The fan function is not just applicable for position. We can use this function for all attributes, also for intensity, color, beams, etc. In our next example, the IS-400 fixtures are selected. We then select the attribute color and choose the CMY option in the color toolbar. The fan mode we choose is the fan left function. In our example, the color magenta has already been turned on. If we now rotate encoder 1, we can see that the color cyan is added from left to right with a fan effect. Tips and tricks. There are two ways to switch the fan function on and off. We have already used one of the options, which is to press the fan key. The second option is to keep the fan key pressed and rotate the encoder at the same time. In our example, we select the fan center option for the fan mode, and then keep the fan key pressed on the keyboard. If we release the fan key, the chimp automatically returns to the normal mode and the fan function is switched off. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Infinity strives to keep its chimp-related tutorials and software information up to date. Keep an eye on our social media channels for the latest information on the chimp.